Hello students, welcome to Hari Chemistry. So this session we will discuss what is water technology and what is hardness of water and causes of hardness of water and types of hard water. Okay, clear student, right? So what is water technology? So water technology means nothing but it is the process of removal of all impurities which are present in water. Okay, so the process of removal of all impurities from the water and make it useful for domestic and industrial purposes is called water technology or water and its treatment. Isn't it, student? Is that clear? Right. So what is water and water technology, student? The process of removal of all impurities, suspended impurities, colloidal impurities, dissolved impurities, all impurities, removal of all impurities from water and make it useful for domestic and industrial purposes is called water technology and water and its treatment. Okay, clear student, right? So what is hardness of water? Then we will move to what is hardness of water. What is hardness of water, right? So hardness is the property or characteristic of water which does not produce lather with soap. That is hardness of water. Okay, student, right? So what is hardness of water, student? Right, so hardness of water, is the property or characteristic of water which does not produce lather with soap. That is hardness of water. Okay, clear, right? So hardness of water is the property or characteristic of water which does not produce lather with soap. Water is due to the presence of certain salts like Ca+2, Mg+2 and other heavy metals are dissolved in water. Clear student, right? So generally the hardness of water is due to the presence of certain salts like calcium, magnesium and other heavy metals are dissolved in water. Okay, so based on this water, when water is treated with soap, so based on reaction with soap with water, generally the water is classified into two types, student, right? So that is soft water and second one is hard water. Clear, right? So what is the formula of soap, student? So soaps are nothing but, student, so soap is equal to sodium or potassium salts of higher fatty acids. Example sodium stearate, that is equal to C17H35COONA. So this is the formula of soap. Okay, when the soap is treated with water, so generally the water is classified into two types, that is soft water and hard water. So what is soft water, student? Right, what is soft water? The water which produce lather with soap is called soft water. The water which produce lather with soap is called soft water. Okay, right. So when soap is react with water, so means this is the sodium salt of stearic acid or sodium salt of stearic acid. So stearate, sodium stearate react with water. So then it react with water, it forms C17H35COOH+NaOH. So when the soap is treated with water, it gives lather easily, then we can say it is soft water. Okay, right. So what is hard water, student? The water which does not produce lather with soap is called hard water. Okay, right. So the water which does not produce lather with soap is treated with soap. So soap formula is C17H35COONE. So it is soap soluble, is react with dissolved salts of calcium chloride and magnesium chloride. So these are salts which are present in water. So these salts are soluble. So react with soap, it form C17H35COO taken twice into Ca+2. Or so we can write as C17H35COO taken twice into Mg+2 plus 2NaCl or MgCl2, here also 2NaCl, okay. So it forms CaCl2 here, so 2NaCl and MgCl, okay. So it forms precipitate. When the hot water react with dissolved salts of water, so react with calcium chloride and magnesium chloride, it forms some precipitate. So it is insoluble. It is insoluble in water. Okay, so that is of hardness of water. So generally the hardness of water is due to the presence of bicarbonates, chlorides and sulfates, nitrates of calcium and magnesium salts. Okay, so mainly the hardness of water is due to the presence of chlorides, bicarbonates, sulfates and nitrates of calcium and magnesium salts. Okay, so these soluble salts, these salts like calcium chloride and magnesium chloride, calcium sulfate, magnesium sulfate, calcium bicarbonate, magnesium bicarbonate, so these salts gets mixed with the natural water, so then the water becomes hardness. Okay, so these dissolved salts gets mixed with the natural water, so due to the following reason. Okay, so the first reason is when the natural water containing carbon dioxide so flows over the rocks of limestone, means calcium carbonate and dolomite, calcium CaCO3, MgCO3, so the water containing carbon dioxide, so here you can see the reaction CaCO3. Okay, so the water flows over limestone, so the water containing carbon dioxide, so this carbon dioxide flows over the rocks of limestone or a dolomite, then the water gets converted into So soluble calcium bicarbonate, or if it is react with magnesium or carbonate, then it converted into magnesium bicarbonate. So it's converted into bicarbonates. Okay, so the natural water containing carbon dioxide flows over the rocks of limestone CaCO3, dolomite CaCO3, MgCO3. They get converted into bicarbonate. So these carbonates are react with water and it converted into bicarbonates. Hence water gets hardness. Okay, so generally the water hardness of water is due to the presence of bicarbonates, chlorides, sulfates and nitrates. Okay, right. Next, when natural water flows over the rocks containing chlorides, sulfates and nitrates of calcium and magnesium, so salts are dissolved in water. So these salts are dissolved in water, thus water gets hardness. So these two following reasons causes hardness to the water. The bicarbonates causes to the hardness, chlorides, sulfates and nitrates are also causes to the hardness of water. So the natural water gets converted into hardness of water. So due to the presence of dissolved salts of calcium and magnesium, chlorides, sulfates and bicarbonates, so small amount of nitrates. Okay, types of hardness of water. Okay, right. So hardness of water is mainly classified into two types. So the classification is based on depending upon types of dissolved salts which are present in the hard water. So the hard water is mainly classified into two types. The first one is temporary hardness and second one is permanent hardness. Okay, so temporary hardness we can also called as carbonate hardness. We can also called as carbonate hardness and also called as alkaline hardness. Alkaline hardness. So permanent hardness we can called as non-carbonate hardness. Non-carbonate hardness, or we can called as non-alkaline hardness. Non-alkaline hardness. Clear student, right? So temporary hardness we can called as carbonate hardness, alkaline hardness. Permanent hardness we can called as non-carbonate hardness and non-alkaline hardness. Okay, right. So what is temporary hardness, student, right? So temporary hardness, so we can called as temporary hardness, carbonate hardness and alkaline hardness. What is temporary hardness, right? So temporary hardness of water is due to the presence of bicarbonates of calcium, comma magnesium salts. Okay, so the temporary hardness of water is due to the presence of bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium salts. That is causes temporary hardness to the water. Okay, so the solubility or the presence of these bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium, the water gets temporary hardness. Okay, right. So generally the temporary hardness we can remove easily by heating. We can remove easily heating or boiling. The second point, so we can remove temporary hardness of water by adding lime to water. Clear student, by adding lime to water. So lime means calcium hydroxide, lime to water. Okay, for example, so we can heat the temporary, we can remove the temporary hardness. So generally the temporary hardness of water is due to the presence of bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium salts. Okay, right. So we are heating, that is the symbol of heating. Here what will happen, so it is dissociate into calcium carbonate as a precipitate plus water and it releases carbon dioxide. Okay, so we can heat the magnesium bicarbonate, so it gets into magnesium hydroxide plus 2 moles of carbon dioxide. Clear, student? Right. So that is we can remove easily by heating of temporary hardness of water. Okay, so adding bicarbonate, adding lime to water, so we are adding calcium hydroxide as lime. So here it converts into magnesium hydroxide plus 2CaCO3 plus 2 moles of water. So these two methods we can remove the temporary hardness easily. One is by heating of water and by adding lime to water. Clear, student? So this is about temporary hardness, permanent hardness. So permanent hardness is due to the presence of chlorides, comma sulfates of Ca plus 2, comma Mg plus 2. Okay, so the permanent hardness of water is due to the presence of chlorides, comma sulfates of calcium and magnesium salts. Calcium and magnesium salts. Okay, right. So permanent hardness we cannot remove by boiling. So permanent hardness of water, so we cannot remove by heating, but we can remove by lime soda process and so zeolite method. Okay, so it is not easy to remove permanent hardness, means it is not easy to remove chlorides and sulfates which are present in the water, but some chemical methods are there. So by remove lime soda process and zeolite method. Okay, clear, student? So this is about permanent hardness. Once again I will recall, what is temporary hardness? The types of hardness mainly so classified into two types depending upon the types of dissolved salts which are present in the water. So the first one is temporary hardness and second one is permanent hardness. Temporary hardness we can called as carbonate hardness or alkaline hardness. So temporary hardness is due to the presence of bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium salts. Temporary hardness we can remove easily by heating or boiling and adding lime to water. So second one is permanent hardness. The permanent hardness is due to the presence of chlorides, sulfates of calcium and magnesium salts. We cannot remove easily by heating, but we can remove by some chemical methods or chemical techniques, that is lime soda process and zeolite method. Okay, clear, student? So this is about types of hardness of water. Clear? Thank you.